The Huawei P10 features a fingerprint sensor-laden home button, dual Leica-branded rear cameras, and a metal body. The P10 Lite features none of these traits. So is this phone just trying to ride the coattails of the company's flagship, or is it a solid premium mid-ranger in its own right? Rather than taking cues from the P10 and P10 Plus, aesthetically, the P10 Lite looks like a subtle evolution of its predecessor. You get a glass front and back with nicely rounded edges, a squared, sturdy metal frame broken up by a few antenna lines, and a rear-mounted fingerprint sensor. Like the company's other phones, picking the right colour is key to minimising the appearance of smudges and fingerprints, which are inevitable where glass-bodied handsets are concerned. We appreciate the tactile textured hardware controls too, but were hoping for the convenience and future-proofing that USB-C affords, rather than the now aging micro-USB standard that the P10 Lite sports. Despite the name, the P10 Lite is not only larger and heavier than the vanilla P10, but it also packs in a bigger 5.2-inch display as well. It's arguably one of the nicest aspects of the phone though, with impressive contrast, especially from a mid-ranger with an LTPS LCD. Its full HD resolution renders text and imagery cleanly, and it prioritizes accuracy over vibrancy with regards to color. As for the audio experience, there's a single downward-facing speaker behind the grille on the phone's bottom edge that pushes out clear but uneventful sound. And despite thinning down from its predecessor, you can also expect a conventional 3.5mm headphone jack in there too. Like the beefier P10s and Honor's most recent efforts, the P10 Lite sports the latest iteration of the company's Android overlay out the box, Emotion UI 5.1 running atop Android 7.0 Nougat. We've already waxed lyrical about the huge improvement 5.1 is over older iterations of Huawei's user experience, but its key tenets fall into three main areas. Firstly, the company has tidied up the interface so that it's simpler to use, plus the option of adding in an app store and a global search bar are super convenient. Secondly, the themes app and other customization options make the P10 Lite incredibly easy to personalize. Whilst the software's talents in background optimization via Huawei's Ultra Memory and Ultra Response initiatives make sure the phone feels fast and will remain snappy over its lifetime. This is the first phone we've encountered sporting the company's own Kirin 658 processor, and on paper it's comparable to Qualcomm's Snapdragon 65, the chipset powering last year's Huawei Nova and Nova Plus. It packs plenty of punch for everyday use, and paired with 4GB of RAM on the P10 Lite, seems more than comfortable sporting split-screen multitasking and running 3D games. As for storage, the UK version packs 32GB, but almost 10GB of that is occupied by the phone's firmware, which would be cause for concern were it not for microSD support up to 256GB. There's also a 3000mAh non-removable battery inside, and it's another gem. You can expect just shy of 2 days of mixed usage per charge, thanks in part to the company's smart power-saving 5.0 tech, and Huawei's 18W quick charger gives you a work day's worth of use, or just over 40%, in just 30 minutes. Sadly, Huawei didn't transpose the P10's dual signature cameras over when selecting the snappers for the P10 Lite, instead giving it a 12MP primary camera with an f2.2 aperture and an 8MP sensor with an f2.0 aperture on the front. Shots typically turn out well exposed with accurate colouring and a pleasingly wide dynamic range, whilst low light shots also come with a surprisingly low amount of grain and noise. A lack of image stability is the main camera's biggest shortcoming, along with an ineffective HDR mode. But if you want a full rundown of the P10 Lite's photographic talents, then check out our dedicated camera review. If it isn't already apparent, the Huawei P10 Lite is clearly more of a refinement upon the P9 Lite than a stripped-down version of the company's P10 flagship, which is a bit of a shame. It lacks the standout features of Huawei's current top dog, and despite being well-built with a great user experience, it's not only forgettable, but it also has to take on the more affordable Moto G5 Plus, and that is no easy task. Hopefully you found our full review of the Huawei P10 Lite useful, and if you want to know more, we also have a tips and tricks video and a camera review to check out on our YouTube channel. Don't forget to subscribe, and you can read more on recombo.com. Thanks for watching.